дорогие друзья,
dear friends,
то, что сегодня
it's impossible to explain what happens today. The Holy Spirit had made a great work. The last summit was really a phenomenon. Something incredible that we can see today. Today are the miracles that God creates. The miracles that God creates this very time on our planet. The breaking of curses, the breaking of curses. I see witchcraft that was done on you. Hundred percent, hallelujah. Oh, Holy Spirit, no demons will live in me anymore. We watched it online and we were shocked at how powerful God moves. It was like the apostle was here with us. We couldn't stand the third day because the anointing swept you simply away. It was so powerful. It touched me. I want to say glory to God for this summit that is over. However, I can't say that it is over. It started because we have just been touched by this power of the Holy Spirit. He visited us. All people write, say, and shout around. We want to continue. We want to see what will happen next. We want to announce this exciting news to every person. The summit is not over. It will continue. Every day, during 1 month, you will get a lesson where I will teach you to fellowship with the Holy Spirit. And teach you about studying the fourth dimension and give you teaching about grace. I will also pray about the healing from different diseases and the deliverance from specific spirits every day. Before the summit, we will walk a very interesting, fantastic way. We will experience the real presence of God. And we will come absolutely free to this summit. We will come in triumph and victory of Jesus Christ to this awesome event, experiencing His grace. Dear friend, soon there will be next summit, and I invite you. It's something incredible. It has changed my destiny also. It was something awesome. I'm looking forward to the new summit. They say that the registration is on. Maybe you pray for many years and you don't see the answer. But during these 3 days, you can experience the greatest glory of God. Thank you to the Apostle and Pastor Victoria that they always go all the way. Register to the summit. Don't miss this event. If you hear now about the summit, just run to it. Don't look at any obstacles. Just don't hesitate. Just run there. This is what you need that will change your life.
Дорогой друг,
dear friend,
каждый день апостол Владимир будет молиться за исцеление конкретных болезней и разрушение проклятий. Счастливое и здоровое будущее – это судьба от Бога для тебя.
The Holy Spirit is a person. The grace of Jesus Christ is the thing that cannot be achieved. This thing is impossible to earn and it cannot be deserved. When you try to deserve the grace of Jesus Christ, you actually find yourself without it. But today, I would like to give you some advice. Look, how you can find yourself in such a situation when you truly deserve this grace? When you try to find the way out of your problems and place yourself on the right path to be worthy of this grace. But you have to understand that as soon as you try to be worthy of the grace, you lose it immediately. At this particular moment, right now, look at your mistakes. Look at yourself. Let's look at the most disgusting situations that one can ever imagine. Let's look at something you want to hide. Something that you don't like about yourself, and you want to change it in order to come to God. Because you really don't want to come with this to God. Please listen up and look at this situation. Look at such a situation when you're trapped. You did something wrong, and now you're waiting for some troubles. You should know that it is the right time to raise your eyes up to the sky. Raise your eyes to God and think that at this very moment, right now, the grace of Jesus Christ is given to you. And God says through the Apostle Paul that we have to completely rely on this grace. If you try to do something on your own to become a little bit better in order to receive this grace, you lose it. Therefore, no one will be declared righteous in God's sight by the works of the law. The scripture says that through the law we become conscious of our sin, but you cannot become conscious of freedom. Grace and the truth are the things giving us freedom. Then you will know the truth, and the truth will set you free and give you mercy. So we are having a practical lesson with you at this moment without changing anything the way you really are. Just make a pause for a second. Stop for a second and try to understand that at this moment, when you stop, the grace is flowing onto you. Right now, along with me, let's do the following thing. Close your eyes and deeply realize that you're hopeless, that you're really doomed, that you cannot change anything by yourself. At this very moment, you're 100% doomed sinner. Please realize that the grace of Jesus Christ is actually His present and undeserved gift. It is His righteousness. It is His forgiveness. Right now, keep your eyes closed. Imagine how His forgiveness is coming to you from the throne of God. Forgiveness. At this moment, all you need is to be in such a deep condition that you're a sinner. And despite of this, you receive forgiveness. You cannot deserve it. This is what grace means. One of the features of grace is forgiveness. And you cannot deserve this forgiveness. You cannot earn this forgiveness somehow. You cannot receive it for something. That is why, right now, knowing that you cannot do anything, you just receive this forgiveness. And this forgiveness comes right into your soul, into your heart, into your spirit, as if you get dressed into his this forgiveness. God put a gown on you. On this gown it's written, forgiven, forgiven, forgiven. Katalasso, katalasso, katalasso. This is the words that Jesus shouted out at the very end on the cross. It's paid off. This is the meaning of the word katalasso. This was the sign on the goods that had been sold. Listen, at this moment, right now, you're standing covered with this gown, where it's written, forgiven, 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 paid, paid, paid. The grace is paid. And today, this lesson of grace is not just a lesson. I'm coming with you into this grace. You're dressed into this grace. Right now, you're dressed. Take this gown with your hands. Take it with your hands now. Imagine it literally and take it. Grab it, squeeze it, and say, I will not let it go. And I'm forgiven. I'm forgiven. I'm given forgiveness in the name of Jesus Christ. I'm given forgiveness in the name of Jesus. And starting from this moment, from this day, I'm forgiven. And now, please keep your eyes closed. Hold this gown right now and say, I will not let it go. Anointing is coming right now. Hallelujah. I will not let this gown go. I will never let it go. This is my personal gown. Jesus was dying for me. He was dying for my sins on the cross. Those were my sins that were put onto Jesus. Those were my sins that were put onto my Lord. Those were my sins that He took onto Him. All my fault, He completely took it upon Himself. That is my condemnation that He took unto Himself. I cannot walk under any condemnation. Say it along with me. I'm saying these words and you're saying them with me in your spirit. I cannot walk under condemnation. I cannot bear the feeling of guilt because Jesus took away my faults. It was my guilt and He took on the cross and in turn He gave that gown forgiveness. Say it with me, the gown of justification. It is written on it. Justification, justification. We're justified in the name of Jesus. The word justification is a juridical terminology and it's used in courts and cases when the person is not guilty, when he was found innocent because he was justified. He hadn't done anything. The sacrifice of Jesus Christ is so powerful that when the Heavenly Father is looking at you right now, He finds you as 100% righteous person dressed into this gown because He sees that you have never committed any sin in your life, as the blood of Jesus Christ is so powerful. The blood of Jesus Christ is so powerful. That is why right now, this very moment, right now, you're holding this gown and saying, I'm justified. Hallelujah. I cannot be in touch with the feeling of guilt. I have nothing in common with this feeling. Condemnation has nothing in common with me. The rest of the condemnation can have nothing in common with me. This is a sin. This is wrong because Jesus suffered so much and there is nothing that can race against me and accuse me. Holy Spirit, thank you. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Holy Spirit. The grace of Jesus Christ, the grace of Jesus Christ is so powerful. The grace of Jesus Christ is so powerful. Keep this gown. Keep this gown. Hold it and say, I'm dressed into this gown and God dressed me in it forever. It will last forever. I'm dressed in this gown. Jesus has died on the cross. He died on the cross for my sins. You must not walk under condemnation. He died for my sin. He died for my sin. Think about something that can upset you very much, something that can destroy you from inside, some kind of a sin. Think about it and think that Jesus died for it. He has taken this sin on Himself. He died for this sin. He bore this sin on Himself. And this sin has no power over you. This sin doesn't rule anything in your life. This sin has nothing in common with you because Jesus connected with this sin in order to disconnect you from it forever. That is why today you're a new creation. It is written on this gown. new creation. Hallelujah. It's written that you're free. You're free. You're free from your guilt. And this sin doesn't destroy you anymore. There is nothing wrong. You don't even trust the symptoms. Even if the sickness is knocking at your door, the sickness can appear as a symptom in a person's life. If a person reacts to a symptom, surely the devil will deceive him. This is a lie. The symptom is a lie, and the devil comes through the symptom. Listen, don't accept any symptoms. Stay in faith. Sin is like a sickness. It may knock it into your life. It may knock again and again, as if it really exists, as it has power. Anointing is here when I'm speaking. And if it's still there and keeps destroying you, don't believe the symptoms. Even it seems that you're sick and sin again. No, don't believe it. Say, I don't accept this because I'm free. This is the devil who is lying to me. Let him try to lie to me even 100 times. I don't believe him. I know that my sin is on the cross. My sickness is on the cross. My sin is on the cross. Say it with me. My sin is on the cross. My sickness is on the cross. My sin is on the cross. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Say it with me. My sin is on the cross. My sickness is on the cross. Today I'm healthy. Today I'm completely healed from this sin. I'm healed from this sickness. I'm healthy. Today the grace of Jesus Christ is absolutely operating. I'm free. I'm forgiven. I'm absolutely forgiven. Say it with me. I'm absolutely forgiven, 100%. I'm 100% righteous person. I'm 100% righteous person. Hallelujah. I'm 100% free person. Because Jesus took slavery on himself. He did it. 100%. And there is not any slavery in your life anymore. I don't accept any sickness. I don't accept it. And there is nothing that can destroy me right now, because say it with me now. I'm 100% righteous person in Jesus Christ. I'm 100% righteous person in Jesus Christ. I'm 100% righteous person in Jesus Christ. Thank you, Holy Spirit. 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 Thank you. Hallelujah. And today, my dear friends, I'm praying for you. Let the anointing that is moving, Holy Spirit, who is touching you today, thanks to the sacrifice of Jesus Christ, let it be on you. Hallelujah. You're free. You're healed. You're healed from the guilt. You're healed from the condemnation and self-condemnation. You're healed. You're healed. You're redeemed. Hallelujah. You're forgiven. You have this forgiveness. You're a new creation. This is who you really are. Say it with me. A new creation. I'm a new creation in Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for this time and for this lesson. Thank you. Thank you for this summit. Thank you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let it be so. Amen. 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 Amen.
Dear friend, hurry up to get registered to the Summit the Four Dimensions that will be held from July 30th to August 1st. To register, please call 646-980-6988 or use the link in the description.